Welcome to Highline Excel 2013 class video number 7. Hey, if you want to download this week 2 workbook, click on the link below the video. In this video, we want to talk about 3 different types of references or cell references. We want to talk about sheet reference, workbook reference, and a 3D reference. Now, here's the first one. We're going to talk about sheet reference. We have a schedule of accounts receivable, and here's the balance, the AR, accounts receivable balance. Over on the controlling account sheet, we also have a balance. And in accounting, you need to check whether these are in balance. So over here, that means I need to have this cell on sheet CR8 in one formula, and I need the cell A5 from the CAR sheet. No problem. You ready? Equals, and then I'm going to click on this B11, that's just on this sheet. Are you equal to? Now, here's the sheet reference. The first thing is you click on the sheet, boop. Then you click on the cell in the sheet, boop. You can see up here CAR explanation point. That's a sheet reference. Notice that's the sheet name, CAR. The explanation point is the syntax for sheet reference. And then A5. Now you hit Enter. What you don't want to do is click back on the sheet, Enter. And so F2, we can see our formula there. Now let me just show you something. We don't have any spaces in this name, so there's no little single apostrophes. If I were to change, I mean, just like anything in Excel, if I change the sheet name, then of course the formula will change. F2, it's got to, sheet references have to have single apostrophes if there's a space. If I come back over here and get rid of it, F2, there we go. So sheet references. Now let's go look at CR9, and we'll talk about a workbook reference. Now here we have a formula for current net income, F2. This is for June. Now I'm going to assume that the May net income is in a different workbook. And what we're going to do, so you can do this while you're watching the video, is we're going to cut this, Control X. I'm going to open up a brand new workbook with the keyboard, Control N. That's the letter N, Control N. Control V. I'm going to Control Roll just to make it a little bit bigger. Name this sheet. F12 to save as, and you can save it wherever you want. Oops, I hit that, did the cardinal sin. I left it book 1, F12. I'm going to call it. Now this workbook name will show up in our formula. So that's very important. It helps us identify, right? So then I'm going to click that. All right, now you ready? The keyboard to jump back and forth between windows is Alt-Tab. So I'm holding Alt and hitting the Tab key. So I could use this, but there's a keyboard just to jump back and forth between the open Excel workbooks. It's Control-Tab. So Control-Tab. All right, you ready? So May net income equals Control-Tab. And now I'm going to click on Revenue. Notice right up here it puts the actual name of the workbook file and when square brackets. When we close this, it'll actually put the whole file name in. And then it says May explanation point because it's got a sheet reference, and then absolute reference. Now, it by default comes up as absolute. It's easy enough to change that. You just put your cursor up there and change it, but that'll be fine. And then I'm going to type minus sum, open parentheses of this whole range right here. Close parentheses. Those are 2 workbook references. So now when I hit Enter, F2, you can see we have some workbook references. Now, another way to do that is if, there I calculated it. It might make more sense, Control Tab, to actually calculate the net income over here, right? And we only have to have a single, I'm going to Control Up Arrow, minus SUM, Tab, Up Arrow, hold Shift, up, 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 up with my up arrow, close parentheses, Control Enter. So F2, that is our formula. Control Tab. It might make more sense to do the formula over there and then say equals, Control Tab, and click on that cell. Now we have workbook reference, sheet reference, and an absolute cell reference. Again, if we had to change this, like copy this down, F2, you just take your cursor and touch it and then hit F4, and make it whatever you want. That's fine for us because we're not copying it anywhere. Now the change equals, hey, the current month minus the previous month, and then we get a change. Now, Control Tab, Control S, and let's close this. Now watch what happens. Right here, F2, so it puts the whole file name. That's how it knows how to communicate. All right, now let's close this, save. I'm going to close it. Open it from wherever you have it. And if this were to change, Control S, Alt F4. And now when we open up our workbook with our workbook references, it's going to ask us, hey, workbook contains links to one or more external sources and could be unsafe. Hey, I'm going to click Update. Because I know that it's safe, and instantly it updates. Now, if you ever move that workbook, it may not be able to communicate. You can reestablish a link by going up to Data, Edit Links, and then you can update. That's if you initially click Don't Update, change the source, open the source, break the link. Sometimes you no longer want it, you know, have that your number's done. You don't want that dialog box to pop up anymore when you open your workbook. Change source here. That means you'd go and re-find it and double click on the workbook and reestablish. All right, close. So workbook links. Now let's go over and look at our third type of reference. I'm going to click on the corporate sheet, and we want to talk about 3D cell references. I'm going to use my navigation arrows to expose some more sheets, because here's the deal. We have a template, products January through April. And we have three stores, Oakland, Seattle, Tacoma. And we want to, on the corp sheet, add up all of the product ones for January from across three sheets. Now let's go look at this sheet, Oakland. Well, January product one is in B3. Same on Seattle, B3, and same on Tacoma. So this 3D cell reference works when the layout on all the different sheets are exactly the same. Now notice, what is it that we want? We want the B3 from across 1, 2, 3 sheets. That's why it's called 3D, because we're going to get the same cell, B3, 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 as if they're on top, one on top of each other from across three different sheets. And you can have as many sheets as you want. All right, ready? We're going to add those. So I'm going to use sum. Then I come over, and step one is I click on the sheet. So far, it's looking like a sheet reference. I click on B3 on the first sheet. Notice, looking just like a sheet reference. But watch this. Before I click on the last sheet, Tacoma, hold Shift. When I click on Tacoma, instantly this is highlighted. And look what happened up here. We have Oakland, colon, Tacoma, B3. And that colon is awesome, because just like a regular range of cells, if I were to insert a sheet between the two bookends, Oakland and Tacoma, this formula would totally update. All right, that's a relative cell reference. I'm going to close parentheses, Control Enter. F2 just to admire that handiwork. Now I can copy this down and over. Down and over. Go to the last one, F2. So now it's looking at all of the E8s from across Oakland to all the way to Tacoma sheet. If you were to insert a sheet, so I'm going to Shift F11. And then let's say I copied this just to show you that it works. Let me put delete everything here. I'm going to go over to the corporate total. OK, so January is 31. If on this sheet, this is a new store, this is Burien. just to give us a big number so we can immediately see 5,000. Instantly over here, it updates. The formula doesn't look like it changed, but just like regular ranges of cell, we have bookend, colon, bookend, so anything inserted in between updates. Now here we did a cell reference. We could also do, and if we wanted to do a range of cells from across some sheets, we could do that. So I go equals sum. Now I'm going to click, I just want January. I don't want the individual products. Now I'm going to click on the first sheet, highlight the whole range. You could see up here it says Oakland B3 to B8. That's a range. Now hold Shift, and hold Shift before you click on Tacoma, and then Tac. Instantly we see our formula, close parentheses, Control Enter. And so now I can copy this over, click on the last one, F2. Absolutely amazing. So that's a 3D cell reference. We also saw a sheet reference and a workbook reference. All right, next video we'll talk about table references in formula table nomenclature. All right, see you next video.